friends, I'm Walker, and welcome back to All of Av Nails, where we talk about vegan and cruelty-free nail polish. Today is a video that I have been looking forward to since springtime, quite literally. Today is our Summer Picks collab, our faves for summer collab. We have now done 4 full seasons. We started last year with the Fall Picks collab, then we did winter, spring, and now here we are in summer. In the description box down below, you will see a link to a list of all the channels that are participating in this collab, and I hope that if you are a follower of mine, if you like my channel, that you'll go check out that list, because I'm sure that there is someone else that you would enjoy watching, because there is such a wide variety of channels, of creators, of nail polish lovers, and I just can't wait for you to find somebody that you are gonna enjoy. If you are new to my channel, coming from one of those, welcome! I'm so glad to have you here. My name is Walker, and on this channel we talk about vegan and cruelty-free polish. So in the past couple seasons, what I have done is gone through color by color and picked my favorite reds, oranges, yellows, etc., etc. for the season. And so that's what we're gonna do today. So let's dive in and start talking about red. All right, so I think that there are really a couple categories of red cream that I love in the summertime. I like really juicy, kind of berry-y polishes. And the two that I picked to represent that are Sonja, which is this really lovely, kind of corally red color. It's like a little bit red, a little bit pink. It's absolutely stunning. Zoya has several of these. They have Virginia, they have Dixie, they have this one, they have Kylie is a little bit more pink, but it's very similar too. Sonja is my favorite. I don't really know why, but I really enjoy it. All of them have really great formulas. So if you have any of those that kind of fit in this category, I think they're really perfect for summer. The other kind of reds that I really enjoy are more like fiery, orangey reds. So this one is Demetria. This one has a really gorgeous like blood orange color. It's absolutely stunning. It's really, really gorgeous. And so I really like these like red orangey ones for summer. All right. And then I did want to pick one kind of non-cream color. I picked Needy, N-I-D-H-I. This one is really pretty. It was a summer release. It is a really gorgeous, like deep red base, and it has tons of gold glitter in here, like gold shimmer in here. They're kind of bigger particles so you can see them on the nail. It reminds me a little bit of Robbie from the Barefoot collection, which was their most recent summer collection, but this one is absolutely gorgeous. These glitters just like gleam off your nails. They catch in the sunlight. It's really a perfect summer polish. For oranges, I had two kind of categories in my mind. One are these like super fiery, what I'm wearing today, neon orange. These are perfect for summer. I love, this is probably my favorite neon to wear. I like really bright yellow, but I think orange is my favorite. I think it looks the best on my skin tone. I was so happy with Muy Caliente, which is from the Orly summer collection for 2019. This one is amazing. The formula is so great. It gets opaque for me in 2 coats. I have almost no nail line unless my nails are like super, super long, but this one is a little bit more almost like roasty, like it has a little bit more depth to it than Zoya's Posse, which is what I'm wearing right now. This one is a little bit more jelly. It's more like a traffic cone. It's like super neon orange. I'm wearing it in 2 coats and I do have a little bit of nail line, which doesn't really bother me, honestly. I don't think you can see it unless you're looking for it. But if you're looking for something with a little bit better coverage, a little bit more depth, I think Muy Caliente is a really good pick. But either of these are gorgeous. So Orly's Muy Caliente or Zoya's Paz. All right, and then the other kind of orangey category that I really love in this summer is a good like terracotta-y orange polish. I think these are a really nice neutral polish for the summer that still packs some interest and some punch. So the first one that I'm thinking of is Red Rock Crossing, and this is actually a matte from the Color Club Sedona Summer Collection, and I love this one. It's my favorite from the collection. The rest of that collection I kind of didn't love. I don't know, they were fine. But this one is super gorgeous. It's like 1 coat, almost opaque in 1 coat. I think probably 2 coats is what I will wear it in, but it's matte. So you just throw it on, you walk out the door. I can see this as a really nice quick summer manicure that will go with almost any occasion. And then Circolor's Bowery has a little bit more like oomph, a little bit more punch to it. But it's a really nice terracotta-y color. It's very similar to Kale Polish Miami Fever, so if that's a polish that you like, this one's very, very similar. That one will be in a dupes video soon. But I really like both of these. This color is just a neutral that I absolutely love in the summer. I think it's really perfect. All right, and then for yellows, I have two. I was just smitten with Zoya's Bee when it came out this spring. I love this soft yellow. I wear soft yellow all spring, all summer. I think it's a gorgeous color, and Bee has one of the best formulas that I've tried. It also has this little bit of like warmth to it. It's a little bit creamy. It's really pretty. It's really, really, really nice. I would suggest putting a wide brush in this one. I think it will help make the application just that much easier. If you don't have a wide brush, it's not a crisis. This one is still really nice, and I will link to my color comparison video for the Barefoot collection up above, because if you want to see how this one fits in with the other yellows in Zoya's collection, I think that's a pretty helpful video, so I'll link that one up above. All right, and then if you've been following my channel recently, you know that I've been obsessed with this polish. This is Polish Ballad of Lemons, and I don't even know what to say. I love it so much. It is a super bright, vibrant neon yellow base packed with gold flakies, and this finish is stunning. The base is stunning. It looks stunning on the nail. I'm absolutely obsessed with this polish, and I can't wait to wear it again this summer. So that's Polish Ballad of Lemons. All right, and then I think my longtime viewers will be very impressed with me. I only picked 3 greens. Usually I have like 7 greens, but I feel like summer is not a season that I pull for my greens. I pull for them in the spring, and I pull for them in the fall. Summer is not a season I pull for them very much, but there are a few that I do love. I do really love Josie. Josie is this really pretty kind of muted jade cream from Zoya. It's super soft, it's super delicate on the nails, so it's bright and it's vibrant, but it has this like subtleness and softness that I think makes it super wearable. So this is Zoya's Josie. And then of course I have to pull out my super vibrant teals and turquoises. I think my favorite is probably Cecilia. This one is just absolutely stunning. It's like super fun, super rich. It has a lot of blue in it, which I think, I just love blue polish, but it has this like kiss of green that makes it something special, something unique. So this is Cecilia, and I absolutely love this one. And then of course, it wouldn't be a summer video if I didn't pick out some super vibrant greens. I really enjoy Kale Polish 305. Since that one's discontinued, I wanted to offer one that's not discontinued. This is Palette Polish Pistachio, and this one is very close. It has more green than 305 does. 305 is a little bit more muted, a little bit more yellow. Pistachio is super bright. It is definitely green, and I absolutely love this one. It has a gorgeous, gorgeous formula, almost opaque in one coat, I would say, but I definitely wear it in two. So this is Palette Polish Pistachio. All right, I did a good job with green, but I picked a few more blues. Don't hate me. Blue is gorgeous, especially in the summer. It's like refreshing on your nails. And I would say that in the summer, I like two kinds of blues. I like super punchy, vibrant blues, cobalt blues, like Walker from Zoya. And Walker is a really gorgeous, like, I think I can wear this one in two coats. Some people said it needs 3 for them, but I really like it in two coats. It's just a little bit blue, like a hint of purple, and it's perfect for the summer because it's super bright. So this is also from Zoya's Barefoot collection, and obviously I love the name, but I also really love the polish. All right, and then in summer, I really like blues that have a lot of white in them. So my favorite blue from Zoya ever, it even beats Walker, is Yummy. This one has so much white. It's really, really light. It's really, really vibrant. I absolutely love this polish. And every summer, I want to wear this. I just get so excited when it comes up because it's so gorgeous. So this one is, I think, like a cornflower blue. It has a lot of white in it. It's really, really soft. It's really, really bright and vibrant at the same time. I love this one. So this is Yummy. Dory is pretty close. I've done a comparison of Yummy and Dory, and so I'll link that video above if you want to see it. But Yummy is my favorite of literally every blue polish I've ever worn. I also really enjoy a little bit more periwinkle polishes, but I like periwinkle that leans on the blue side and not the purple side. I like all periwinkles, but my favorites are ones that lean a little bit more blue. So for example, this is Amalfi Love by London Town Lacquer. This is a pretty close dupe for Kale Polish St. Clair, but it is a little bit deeper. It has like a kiss more purple in it than St. Clair does. Since St. Clair is no longer available, or soon will no longer be available, I wanted to share Amalfi Love. This one is a really gorgeous formula. It's a really lovely, like super white-based blue, and it's absolutely stunning, and I can't wait to get this one back on my nails. All right, and then I have to share this new one from Cirque Colors. This is Anchors Away, and when I swatched this polish, my jaw like literally dropped. It's so gorgeous. It's this really pretty like periwinkle base, and then the shimmer in here is so strong, and it's like green and a little bit of, you know, pinky purpley shimmer, and then there's this scattering of holographic, and it is just amazing. This polish is gorgeous. I love all their polishes in this finish, but something about this blue base just makes this one feel so summery. It's like ocean waves, like on your nails. It's gorgeous. And so this is Cirque Colors Anchors Away. This is from their most recent resort collection. All right, for our last color family, I just have two. I have two purples. I have one from Glam Polish. I just did my review of this collection, the polishes that they very kindly sent me to review. This is Midsummer Night's Madness, and it is an absolutely stunning blurple base with this really strong Aurora Shimmer and Ultra Hollow Glitter. And the Aurora Shimmer in here is like coppery, fiery red. It's so stunning in the purple base, and it's so strong. It's not a subtle shimmer. It is there. It like hits you in the face when you look at this polish. It's so gorgeous. And I wore this one just to swatch it so far, but it is at the top of the list of polishes that I cannot wait to get back on my nails. And then probably my favorite purple cream for summer is Perry, and this is from Zoya. This is one of my favorite purples from Zoya. It's probably my favorite purple that is not a super, super dark purple. I really love like Landon and Layton and those like super almost black deep purples. But if I had to pick one that was not in that category, I would pick Perry. It's so unique. It's so gorgeous. It's like a little bit lavender, maybe? I don't know. This one is so gorgeous. If you haven't tried Perry yet, I honestly think this is a must-have Zoya because it is so unique. It's so stunning, and the formula is obviously gorgeous because it's a Zoya. Cool, awesome. Thanks so much for joining me today. I hope that you enjoyed this video. And like I said in the beginning, I really hope that you'll go check out all the other makers who are making videos today. Let us know what your favorite polishes are. And if you do find another channel that you love, definitely let me know down below. Or if you're here from somebody else's channel, let me know where you came from. And as always, thank you so much for joining me. I can't wait to hang out and chat about nail polish again sometime soon. Bye.